Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolat, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine. I'm here to help you with all the information you need for your heart health and informing you about all the latest treatments in medicine and cardiology. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new video that I post. For my international viewers outside the United States, you can get translated subtitles for this video by touching the mobile screen, then pressing the closed caption CC button and selecting your preferred language from the settings. Heart attacks occur at an increased incidence during the Christmas and New Year period. This has been shown in multiple studies over the past few decades. A known example that I can quote you is that Sir Winston Churchill, the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom from 1940 to 1945, is thought to have suffered a heart attack while visiting the White House in Washington, D.C. during Christmas of 1941. A study published in Circulation in 1999 found that there were 33% more deaths occurring in December and January than in June through September. Another study, also published in Circulation Journal, found two discrete peaks of cardiac deaths, one for the Christmas holiday period and one at the New Year's holiday period. A third study from Sweden, published in the British Medical Journal, found that the Christmas holiday period was associated with higher risk of heart attacks. Specifically, the highest incidence of heart attacks occurred on Christmas Eve around 10 p.m. A fourth study, published in the American Heart Association Journal in 2016, found that in New Zealand, there were significantly more deaths from heart attacks during the Christmas holiday period between December 25th through January 7th. This was an interesting finding since the Christmas occurs over there during the summer period, in contrast to Christmas being in the winter season in the United States and Europe and in the Northern Hemisphere in general. A number of mechanisms have been postulated for the increased risk of heart attacks and deaths during the Christmas and New Year holiday periods. Changes in diet and alcohol. People tend to gain weight during the holiday season and take in more salt, which can put additional stress on their heart. Furthermore, fatty meals can have acute adverse effects on endothelial function of the coronary arteries. In addition, people tend to consume more alcohol during the holidays, and large amounts of alcohol intake over a short period of time has been known to have a negative impact on the heart. So my advice to you is to please not indulge in food, especially fatty food and salty food, and do not indulge in alcohol. Emotional stress. During the holiday season, patients might feel stress for having to interact with relatives whom they may or may not want to encounter, having to absorb financial pressures such as purchasing gifts, traveling expenses, entertaining, and decorating. This obviously puts stress on the body in general and the heart in particular. My advice to you is to try to de-stress during this period by preparing well in advance of this festive period. Increased respiratory problems. Example, upper respiratory infections, influenza infection, particulate matter generated from wood burning fireplaces. My advice to you is to get your influenza vaccine a few weeks before the festive period and avoid to spend a lot of time around wood burning fireplaces. Inappropriate delay in seeking medical attention. Individuals tend to downplay their heart symptoms when they occur and do not seek medical advice, as they want to spend the holiday time at home with family and friends rather than seeking medical advice and spending the holiday period in the hospital. My advice to you is that if you get any heart symptoms in the form of chest tightness, chest pain, or shortness of breath, then please report immediately for medical care. Reduced levels of healthcare staffing or fewer staff members who are familiar with individual patients during the holiday on-call schedules. So individual patients tend to get less appropriate health care than they would have gotten during the non-festive periods. Cold weather leading to increased vascular resistance, coronary artery spasm, hemostasis and thrombus formation, and increased oxygen demand can certainly lead to increased incidence of heart attacks during the festive period. However, an increase in heart attacks during the festive period has also been noted in the southern hemispheres, where Christmas and New Year period occurs in the warm season of the year. My advice to you is to try to avoid prolonged exposure to cold weather during the festive period. So please look after your health and heart during the Christmas and New Year period. If you have any question about what I presented to you today, or any medical question in general, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comment section below, and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching and talk to you soon.